Hello students, I am Dr. Tanmoy Vishwas. I welcome you all in my channel Chemistry, the Mystery of Molecules. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss an interesting topic, or better to say a named reaction, that is Buchner-Curtius-Sauterbach reaction. Okay, this reaction is mainly about the addition reaction between carbonyl and diazoalkanes. So this interesting topic we will discuss today, and today's discussion will mainly focus on few points like the basic idea, reaction mechanism, diazomethane versus other diazoalkanes reactivity, and ketone substituted, ketone migratory preference, etc. Lots of chemistry. How's activity reduced, enhanced, lots of things. So, lots of chemistry to be learned in this video. So, I request you student, please watch the video until the end with complete attention and cool mind. Okay, let's start. So, as usual, you are watching that, what is the reaction? Carbonyl. For example, you can consider this is a CH, this is a R1, R2 and M2. Okay, but by the way, remember that actually in case of diazomethane was CH2N2. We said this is minus, this is plus. Similar thing is possible for other diazoalkane also, and in this case I also agree that there are lots of chemical forms. Okay, so in order to understand the story, I believe you need to understand diazomethane a little bit. I shall come. So this is, and along with that, let's consider this is a ethyl and this is a R prime. Okay. Now, question, in order to understand, in this case, what happens? This diazomethane attacks carbonyl group and ultimately it results, let me tell you the final product. Ultimately, it results an addition product, okay? And that addition product will migrate and rearrange, and ultimately it will result in. So, this is, okay, first let's discuss about the addition thing. I guess it will be a little more complicated. R prime, C, and in this case, this is N2 plus, this is R1, this is R2. Now, this much I guess you have understood. So, let's learn this much first. So, in order to understand the story, you need to understand first the reactivity of diazomethane. What do I mean by this term? See, diazomethane should have lots of chemical forms, and the chemical forms are like, so this one, better instead of drawing it in this way, I should draw it in triple bond N, as it is, as I have written there. So, what can happen? It can push, it can come. So, this is CH2N, so this is plus, this is minus, fine. Now, so this is, I guess, okay, even another chemical form also possible, you can understand that CH2N double bond N minus, this is neutral, this is plus, means this double bond will come here, okay. Now, from this thing, you can understand clearly that in one canonical form, this is the nucleophilic. In another canonical form, this is the nucleophilic, whereas this is electrophilic. Question is, which will be more contributing? And that thing will be decided by the stability of the each canonical form. See, in nucleophilic case, this is actually 8 electron species. In electrophilic case, 6 electron species. We know that the canonical form which is associated with maximum stability will have the best, means maximum extent, contribution. So, this is actually most contributing. But, why I have given? There is one but. And the but is that this is most contributing, but not highly nucleophilic. What do I mean by highly nucleophilic? If you say RMGX, Grignard reagent, RLI, they are highly nucleophilic. Okay, so if you add them, reaction will happen, particular fixed it is. But in this case, so reaction, so not highly electronucleophilic, so less reactive. Okay, so this is less reactive. Okay, so now this thing we will try to understand. By the way, previously I have already discussed a lecture about diazomethane for the preparation of ketone. That's a very short version. So, in this video, we will learn details, because in that video, I have focused direct diazomethane. So, if you want that much, so you can visit, but in this case, some more. So question is, okay, fine, we got it. Now, so this is mild nucleophilic, as we understood. So what it will happen? So these will attack here. So it's a simple carbonyl addition, and this thing is governed by one factor named Burgi-Dunis trajectory. Please visit if you haven't read that. See, now this is also a zwitterionic molecule. This is 1N2 and 1O minus. Okay, so what happens next phase? It can push, and one of group, either one or two. I have given methyl for your better understanding. So path on number one, what it will result? It will result this C double bond O here, R means this methyl migration. So this, and see, just let me give you little overview. So in case of methyl migration, it will push, then methyl group will migrate here and it will leave. And by the way, it could be anyhow, I'm written scene, but it could be other anti-orientation also, because this CC rotation possible. Fine. So in this way, what it will result? This thing plus this C having R1, R2 and methyl. One plus nitrogen. In both case, nitrogen. If path B, that is, means the second one, R migration. So what it will result? In this case, it will result R, sorry. In this case, methyl migrated. In this case, R migrated. So this is CH3, this is, and R1, R2, R. Plus nitrogen. So from this thing, one thing is clear, that nitrogen elimination is a very common phenomenon. So from this thing, you can conclude that nitrogen, which is actually N triple bond N, it is a very stable molecule. Please remember, one of the best living group. Okay, nitrogen, and second, first very stable molecule, second gas. So it will eliminate from the reaction medium such that reaction proceeds smoothly, and formation of NN triple bond. So that is one of the driving force for this reaction. Okay, so N2 elimination is major driving force for these steps. Now in this way we got ketone. So it is very easy, I guess, but is it always? Obviously no. Why? Depending on the migratory aptitude of the group involved. What do I mean by the statement? See, let me draw the structure again. CH3 O minus, sorry, R prime, this is R prime. So R prime, C, R1, R2 and N2 plus. Okay, so this much I guess you have understood. Now the question is, this much, so if the migratory aptitude is low, the condition, migratory aptitude is low. What was the previous case? In this case, the condition was, if the migratory aptitude, meaning is the tendency of migration, means how much the groups are interested to migrate. If the migratory aptitude is high, okay, then it's fine. So if it is low, what can happen? Means this both CH3 or R, nobody is interested. So instead of CH3, you can say another group will come. So what it will, instead of pushing it, what it will do? It will directly attack. It will result. Okay. So what it will result? It will result CH3, CR prime, O, CR1, R2. So this is another product also. Now question, which case, which will be the major product? Okay, so this thing is the next interesting topic for us. Okay, so which group will win this? So if this is hydrogen, aldehyde, then remember, migratory aptitude is very, very high. Okay? Even. So, and second thing, this Bargeron's trajectory, which is attacking of the nucleophile to the carbonyl carbon, is preferred if it's aldehyde because bulkiness is less. Please visit if you feel any difficulty in this methodology understanding this Bargeron's trajectory. I have already uploaded a lecture. So it will attack. Now, if R is H and we know that hydrogen have generally very high migratory aptitude, so it will migrate efficiently. Second point. If another part means if you consider, so okay, fine. So what I told that if it is aldehyde, then it will migrate efficiently. Okay, let me clean the part. So if it is aldehyde, it will migrate efficiently. But if I say nitrobenzaldehyde, means one of the groups, this is O minus, one is hydrogen, one is nitrobenzaldehyde, then what it will expect? R1, and this is, for example, let's draw the N2 opposite side, positive side, sorry. Okay. In this case also it will push and this will go. But student, remember that this during the migration, this carbon gets some positive charge. This is experimental. So positive charge density is created. In order to minimize, this oxygen pushes. So that's why if you compare this benzaldehyde versus nitrobenzaldehyde, the reactivity is far, far less. Means this reactivity is significantly less for this NO2 group. Fine. Point number one. Second, similarly, instead of this, if you have acetone, 2-methyl, this is, then you have a significant thing. Fine. Now, instead of that, if you have one is CH2CH3, then reactivity decreases. Okay. Furthermore, instead of that, if you have CF3, reactivity further decreases. So from this thing, what is clear? That first of all, one need to be hydrogen. Second, if you have electron deficient group attached to this carbon, migratory preference reduces. So if migratory preference reduces, then what happens? This epoxide formation get preferred. Okay, so this is the overall discussion. Now, so from what you have discussed, the basic idea, reaction mechanism, diazomethane versus other diazoalkane. Okay, now question is, what about diazomethane versus other diazoalkane? See, diazomethane is, I believe, the smallest molecule, even most reactive. Fine. Now, the diazomethane's problem is that it is very difficult to handle because volatile. Okay. It's a gaseous molecule, means it's the ether solution is used and it can produce gas very easily, so that's why it has it. But instead of that, if you use substituted diazomethane, then for example, if you take alkyl substituted, it's very difficult to make. But there is another one, diazomethane with electron withdrawing group attached. For example, what do I mean? That is ethyl diazoacetate. This. Or you can take sulfonate, means paratoluene sulfonic. Okay, means you may consider in this way also. This is. Or you can say phosphine oxide derivative, means so now, question is, what is about, what their reactivity? Actually, in this case, by substitution, their reactivity decreases. Because of two reasons. One is bulkiness. So, because see, this is a methyl group, methylene group, CH2 very small. But in this case, these substituents, this bulkiness increases, point number one. And see, this is actually a nucleophilic attack. Nucleophilic attack, and the charge density on the nitro, this nucleophile, plays a significant role. In this case, see, it expected to have a canonical form. What do I mean by the statement? That it can push there, it can open. So whatever what produces OET, this is O minus double bond CH N2. So this is that this delocalization is the reason of their stabilization along with the reason of their low reactivity. So that balance you have to do while you put reaction. When you use this, you have a very less control, but when you use such kind of thing, your control is more. And for example, if it is less reactive, what can you do? So you can do increased temperature. Increase reaction time. Okay, refluxing condition you can do, because generally diazomethane is preferred to do the reaction. It is generally advised to do reaction of diazomethane under ambient condition, because in this case nitrogen production became very much facile and which may result in explosion. So please be careful, student, while you are handling diazomethane. I repeat, diazomethane in your lab. So this is now. So this thing we have understood. So, diazomethane versus other diazomethane. Now, ketone substituent migratory group I have explained, and reaction rate, that thing also I have explained. Now, question comes. The question is about this ethyl diazoacetate. So, in this ethyl diazoacetate, what product you expect? For example, if you react this with an aldehyde. Aldehyde RCHO, whatever you expect, that is RHO minus, this is CH, this is N2, and this is CO2ET. So what happens? It pushes, this hydride goes, nitrogen leaves, and ultimately it results a 1,3 dicarbonyl compound. Okay. So that thing is Roscommac reaction, which we will discuss in next video. And another thing I say, that in this case we told that because of substitution, the activity of diazomethane reduces. Fine. And we know ketone is little less reactive because of its bulkiness, means 2. How this could be improved? One is you increase temperature, as I told. But temperature has a risk because nitrogen gas elimination. But if you want to do the same reaction under moderate mild condition, what can you do? Activate carbonyl. How possible? Add Lewis acid. Okay. So that is also another strategy for this Roscommac reaction. And by the way, if I say you the history, this reaction means Buchner, Cartier, Stotterbeck reaction, it's an old reaction, very early, before 1900. And this is 1970-80, like that. It's not that much, this Roscommac reaction. So you may consider this is the extension of the previous reaction. Okay. So this is the end of this discussion. What we have learned today? We have learned today about the nucleophilic addition of diazomethane to the carbonyl group, specifically if we say ketone, what happened, bulkiness, migratory attitude, and finally its extension, that is the Roscommac reaction. And by substitution, we can control the reactivity of diazomethane, and ultimately we will end up 3. And the most interesting part, using Lewis acid, we can increase the activity, we can change the migratory aptitude. And another thing I also remind you, please remember that hydride, generally hydride has the highest migratory aptitude. Okay, means you may consider the its migratory aptitude is more over phenyl. But there are some exceptional case, student, please remember, where when phenyl is attached to very electron rich groups, then some cases the migratory aptitude of aryl or phenyl could be more compared to the hydride itself. So this is the exception, some exception case you may observe. So this is the end of this discussion. I believe this video may be useful for you. Please write your feedback on the comment box. And thanks for watching. And if you really capable, then please help my channel to grow. First of all, subscribe, press the bell icon. And most importantly, if possible, please support me through Patreon. Because without your support, it's very difficult for me to upload new videos for you. So thank you again. Stay happy, stay blessed. See you in my next video.